Now you can go.
All right, would you like to call this meeting to order? Do roll. Clarity, you want to do the pledge?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. All righty. Kathy, would you do roll, please?
Yes. Lee?
Here.
Hayes?
Here.
Hicken?
Here.
All right.
I would request that we recess the meeting to take a tour of the police station and talk about potential future uses, what we have in mind.
So moved.
Second.
Hicken?
Yes.
Hayes?
Yes.
Lee?
Yes.
So we just...
Everybody good?
Yep.
Okay.
We're recording.
See you, Mike.
All right, I'd like to call this meeting back to order.
Did the votes come out of recess?
No.
No.
You don't have to.
Cool.
You don't even have to vote to go to recess.
Oh, I thought you did. That's first for me.
We did.
Okay. Safe to.
Good tour, thanks, guys. Appreciate it. Everybody?
Well, any feedback, you know, first of all, about the main floor here and the proposed uses of it?
Honestly, I think that, I mean, being able to visualize it was good. I think that it kind of, the basement kind of seeing it, how it laid out, I think the multi-purpose room did not really put a definitive tag on it is a good idea. And then as you guys are designing, talking to architect, whatever, you guys can kind of, I think it needs to be dynamic. And kind of go as you go, we figure out.
And I don't think it's the most pressing issue. You know, certainly we want to use it, but, you know, what's going to happen at some point, the police are no longer going to be in here, and we don't want this to sit vacant for too long after, you know, we got to get in here and do some stuff for this floor to make it usable for Nate's apartment, so be it. But we want to move as quickly as we can to have the transition so it doesn't sit vacant.
What is the cost in doing that? Like, what's the transition from this space to that space? What needs to be done?
And for this building?
Yeah.
First of all, you know, one thing that I would be looking for and we're going to be working on for the 19 budget is, you know, the main thing in this building is the electricity. We've got to get it figured out. So that's going to be one of the main things. You know, if you look at the parking lot outside of, for this facility, it needs repaved. It's in bad shape out back. So economy of scale, we would need to do that. We'd also need to potentially remove some walls in here, but that's not going to be too much. So I think the amount on here, outside the electric, is going to be pretty minimal of what we need to do to make it work. We're going to have to open up the door inside the rest of the chamber. You know, maybe some paint. We talked about seeing what's underneath the carpet, see if there's hardwood potentially. And then back up if there is, get it refinished. Kathy, you know.
Yes.
No, which would be amazing.
Since he's in that office, and we are once the police vacates, my thought would be to just do the whole thing. Do the entire project and then move them.
And just do the basement as a general.
I think first floor and basement done together. I think it makes total sense. I mean, the other contractor.
Basement, though, we're saying, you know, we just want it to be a generic space. So you're saying just finish what we need down there, make it a four-wall space.
Don't move them in here, and then do the basement.
There's the dust to be right back.
Do the whole thing. That's my opinion.
Okay.
Because once you settle the dust and you...
I don't know. I don't, because I want to see what the price tag is.
I guess what we're looking for is what direction are we going with the basement? When we say do the basement, does that mean just...
I think the wall comes out of the middle, all the stuff on the inside, you're painting the floor, and you're cleaning it. I mean, I don't really structurally... Just cover the stuff that could potentially be dangerous, and then it becomes a... So it's a shell right now, but we need it clean and empty and safe.
So we're going to make sure that the police department, I mean, everything down there is theirs, whether it's trash or usable.
They'll need to start in the next couple months to figure that out.
Or they're keeping it, or they're selling it, or they're doing something with it, but that's, everything's going to be out of there.
Right.
Right.
Well, and that's something that they can be doing in the next couple months. But they've got to determine what,
totally be good room for the
I think you hit the nail on the head. Really kind of the next step is to have you and Angela really start pricing this thing out. And when you have those people come in here, they're going to give you ideas, things we didn't think about, why don't you do this instead of that.
I'd want to talk to you, Nathan, about, and you, BJ, about are we going to, are we going to charge the utility bill?
No. We don't charge them right now.
Well,
we used to in an effort to help pay off the building because they were a
Well, there's a logic to it. The logic to it is it's a separate fund. The bad thing about it is I don't believe that that particular department has a lot of extra revenue.
They don't. It would certainly be a hit. And I would
so that part about it would be bad unless rates are raised.
Well, and I would propose, and so you know, you got to look at both sides. We do not charge
right
any water usage for any other city buildings.
Oh, that's a good point.
So I would say if there was a mechanism for that, then yes, we're charging for that.
Well, one of the reasons I suggested it is it's possible if it's done in phases, if the money comes back at a different rate, it's possible that we could. $300 a month isn't going to do it.
It's not much, no.
Right?
It's pretty.
But if there was more, it's possible that money could be banked to build out the basement. And once the basement's built, the rest of the or any other. I mean, for all I care.
And then we can determine those things. Is that kind of what you're saying?
Yeah.
By the way, I'm not a huge proponent of that.
Okay, good.
It's just a thought.
Right.
It's just I'm trying to think about. And you know, the argument could easily be made. Well, think about this. If the finance department is not indeed not moved downstairs, and the current utility department is combined with the room next door. Who is the room
Lap.
Next door? Yeah, that who knows? Maybe
yeah.
Somebody else comes in and desires that space. At which point, that space is generating money.
It could, you know. One, I certainly say we are out of space at the city building. You know, we're talking about.
Well, we're out of space with what we've currently got designated.
With what we currently have as under our use.
And we have more coming.
Put it that way, and we have more coming. You know, I think I don't feel right using utility money that's paid by our customers for non-utility services, meaning, hey, we collect the money from rent from them that is going to be paid by user fees, their bill, to
pay
rent
to the city.
Well,
the argument would be that they're paying the money that they pay for the utilities is going to rent space for, I mean, plenty of cities have their utility departments not in buildings that aren't owned by the city. It happens all over the place.
Not owned by the city.
Not owned by where they.
Yeah.
So they rent.
Meaning, plenty of cities don't have the building that we have on Broad Street.
Yeah. Sure.
Yeah.
And so what they do is they put their utility building in a, or their annexes in a strip mall. So it's not unprecedented. It's just an idea.
That's a good point.
Do you think it would be possible to, you know, and you mentioned it too, Jamie doesn't like to do this, but I said a long time ago when we put the roof on, if we had put a little money away for maintenance on a building, knowing that someday you're going to put a roof on, we wouldn't have had to spend $180,000 for a roof, so why don't you start that, especially with this being a historic building, you start putting something, it doesn't have to be a whole lot, combined with what the chamber gives us, if it was generating, you know, so much a month, just to maintain the building. I mean, the roof's new, the windows are new, the air is new, the heat in the theater is new, except for your upgrades that you're going to do. You're not going to, well, and of course the electricity.
Mm-hmm. Right.
That's going to be a big chunk.
We have to figure out flooring.
And flooring.
What I
think would be.
I just don't think
well,
you're
going to. Take this out.
I just don't think you're going to have that much on a yearly basis.
It's about that narrow.
Right. So it's
and
pretty
it's hardwood.
Thin.
Yeah.
Right. What it's, I have.
It'd be gorgeous.
Yeah, it would be.
Written down is. I mean, well, before I go there, is everybody in agreements that. In agreement that the next step is to have you start pricing to see.
Well, I guess my question is everybody feeling somewhat comfortable with the idea of renting to the chamber and moving the utilities billing office over here? Is that the direction we're headed? And if so, we'll certainly start to price out what we need to do.
I think it makes sense
to do that stuff so we have it available for the
next.
Okay.
Yeah. That would be the recommendation, or when Tommy gives his report to say. Yeah, you know, we didn't receive a lot of feedback.
Yeah,
but right now we're looking at that being the case. Talk about Mel's idea.
Mm-hmm.
So what I'm going to do, because I don't know if everybody heard me, I do have to leave at 5:15 to go to Utica to watch my daughter play, and I know you have one other thing you want to talk about.
I do.
So, and Kathy, if you could pull this and write it, however it comes out here, I'm going to make a motion to council, and I'm not going to make it just yet, but the things that I was going to have you address, we would have you address if council approves, would be, and I'll add this into the motion when I make it, the upstairs would be chamber, utilities, and possibly the mayor. The downstairs would be a multi-purpose room with a storage area and possibly a unisex bathroom. And I don't think I need to include the parking lots because I think that would kind of fall into under everything.
Regardless of what the use is, this parking lot will be.
Is everybody good with that? Did I miss anything?
No, I'm good with it. The only question I have is how much can they legitimately do with everybody here? Like, you know, we have no idea about the carpet.
I don't think we're going to do anything until police is gone. I think it's just to get it in the budget for next year. And once police vacates, that's when we would start working here, correct?
Working, you're saying to get the estimates to come in.
Yeah.
Oh.
We'll be able to work through, hey, come in, pull this off, what's it going to take, here's square footages, to refinish all
I think
that
every
stuff.
Time you have someone walk through to get an estimate, it's a reminder to these gentlemen that we're getting a new building. Right. It's going to happen. We got to move.
Absolutely.
They're excited. They're like a buzz outside.
Will there be a kitchen downstairs?
What's that?
Not a full kitchen. No. Get into commercial code.
I'd like to just note, too, for the record, that we did reach, BJ did reach out to council, and we've not received any feedback other than what Mrs. Carter said in the last meeting.
Right.
With that being said, I'm going to make a motion to council to direct BJ to begin gathering design and renovation quotes for Old Town Hall to include the upstairs being Chamber of Commerce, utilities, possibly the mayor's office. Downstairs would be a multi-purpose room with storage area and possibly a bathroom.
Yes.
And that includes electricity.
Can we include...
That includes electricity.
The, what did you call that where the utility payment area was?
Drive-through.
Well, no, like the drop-off, so that way the hallway is open, so that way the Sterling can access...
Make an office or
the bathroom.
Payment receiving area for the billing clerk.
So that would... I don't think you have to be that specific right now.
Maybe I don't.
I think that falls into the utilities billing.
That's later, isn't it?
Yeah. Okay. So is that... that's my motion. Is that okay? Can we go with that?
It should be a motion to recommend.
Yep.
Yes, to
council. Gotcha. I missed that part. Okay.
And I appreciate you guys letting me jump in here. You know how compassionate I am about the theater and the basement, and obviously this strip piece here. And I am representing the theater a little bit today, and that's all they had asked for is to make sure we can use some restrooms, please, without leaving the premises.
All right. So I would like to make a motion to recommend to council to direct BJ King to begin gathering design and renovation quotes for Old Town Hall to include the upstairs being Pataskla Chamber of Commerce, Utilities Department, and possibly a mayor's office. The downstairs to include a multi-purpose room with storage area and possibly a bathroom.
My suggestion to that right there would say first floor and basement instead of upstairs, because people will begin to think upstairs is the top.
Okay, do I need to do it again?
I would, no, first floor, main floor, whatever we want to call it, so, but I agree.
Do I need to read it again, or am I good with that?
Kathy?
I think everybody understands what you're saying.
All right.
Can I say it one more time?
So there's the motion. So we need to...
We need a second.
Second.
And you ready for roll?
Yeah.
Hicken?
Yes.
Hayes?
Yes.
Lee?
Yes.
And that should be carried forward Monday during committee reports.
Can we get that on the agenda as a motion?
I would just do it as...
Just do it under your committee reports, and then you're going to be making a motion at the end of the year.
Can you email me what I said?
We'll get it to you.
If it recorded.
Okay.
We'll get it to you.
Keep your notes.
I'll keep my notes.
A little late for... So we have a couple minutes. I know Tim had something.
I got a couple minutes.
I just want to talk really quick. The howitzer that is at Veterans Green.
Yes.
The Boy Scouts have asked if they could move it into city property in the winters. They'll test fire it once in a while. They'll make sure, but they'll save wear and tear on it, and they'll fix it at those times. To do that, they were told by the city that we would need to have a motion for the city to accept that piece of property as city property. And that is the goal of every Eagle Scout property or project anyway. I had a meeting with Mike Dalton on Friday. He took me through all that, and I told him, that's fine. Talk to Mr. King. And I don't know, I just want you all to know that I may make a motion, because it is buildings and grounds related, on Monday to accept ownership of the cannon and see if the...
Where would we store it?
Accept the donation.
Accept the donation.
To accept the donation of the cannon.
I think it's great.
They would move it to the storage facility at Foundation Park.
The big shower.
We also offered up the Creek Road Public Service Garage if need be. We have, you know, we gave them a couple options.
Okay.
And they agreed to take over all those responsibilities of moving it and putting it back out.
Perfect.
When the weather gets warm. So, okay. And I don't see them going anyplace. Okay. It's just something that the city
formality.
Said. Essentially, it's that the Parks and Rec Department said, we're not going to be, we don't want to be responsible for moving it or keeping it inside our property.
Okay.
If it doesn't belong to us.
And the scouts are fine with it.
They're fine with it.
Yeah. Cool. Moving and storing and moving
so
and storing.
I recommend making that motion on Monday.
Did that get added to the motion? I didn't see.
It's not on as a motion. Okay. I would just make it during your report.
Okay.
Do we need to let our insurance company know we have another $8,000 to $10,000 piece of equipment?
Yeah, they'll do that.
You know, down the road, I know we have like 1 minute, but down the road, I questioned Mike and I said, do we own the gazebo?
We don't own that property.
We don't own the property. The
no, we don't.
Does.
So what goes down with those? What if somebody trips and falls in the gazebo and breaks their ankle? Who's responsible for it?
Us.
Us.
Because we hold the lease for that property where it's located, and the city made a
conscious decision. And maybe that goes that way, but as more and more projects from the scouts come down the pipeline, it would be nice if we just had in our minds, this is what happens. Mm-hmm. You agree to put, and some things maybe we can delineate, like you're building a stone wall, we don't need to take ownership of it, it's on our property, but you put up a totem pole.
Mm-hmm. Well, the flag pole from Rotary. If the flagpole falls over, that's city property.
City property. Yeah. It would be our responsibility unless, you know, to any damage that occurred because of it falling would be ours, and then the city would choose to whether put up a new one or not, or get a donation of another and accept it.
Okay. It's just something that
we do need to be conscious of.
Yeah, it makes sense.
When, yep. You know, Eagle Scout projects are great. They certainly provide a benefit to the city, but we also have to be aware of ultimately when they're done, those scouts walk away from it, what does that mean for the city?
Yes. Fencing at the cemetery?
We don't own the cemetery.
We don't own the cemetery?
Yeah, we do.
Yeah, we do.
The other ones we do.
Swisher we do.
Those we don't. We don't own the cemetery.
No. They did this in Swisher.
Yeah, the two, the two fencings at the Eagle Scout project, Hampshire boy did.
So I recommend make a motion to accept that.
I will. So just so you guys know, it's coming down the pipe, so you're not caught off guard.
Everybody good?
Move to adjourn.
Second.
Hicken?
Yes.
Hayes?
Yes.
Lee?
Yes. Perfect. Thanks, guys. Sorry I had to kind of rush there at the end.
Thank you.